Shalom, good afternoon. Welcome to A Faithful Life. My name is Emuna Yisrael, and this is day number 17 of the Proverbs Challenge. It's not going to be a long one, people. I'm sneaking this one in. It says, better is a dry morsel and quietness therewith than a house with full of sacrifices with strife. There's something about peace of mind that you can't buy. And even if you got a little bit, sometimes it's worth just having your peace of mind than all of this illustrious promises of, let's just say, for fame and fortune. You know, they promise this and they promise that, and you have the big house and anything you want to eat, but there's no love in it. And it's saying that it's better to have a dry morsel. You ever ate a dry piece of bread and you wanted to choke? Like, dry morsel, no butter, no oil, nothing, just dry. Better that is than a house full of strife and a lot of food. So I could definitely rock with that one. You know what I noticed? I say what I found interesting a lot, and I also say what jumped out at me. So today I'm trying to redirect my words and not say so much of what jumped out and what I find interesting. I'm using my synonyms today. So see how many times I make a mistake and say that. 14 says, the beginning of strife is as when one let out water. Therefore, leave off contention before it be meddled with. You know, you're sitting down and you hear, what's that? What's that dripping? You're not sure that you hear the dripping, but you're like, drip. Drip, drip, drip. And you're like, oh, something is dripping. It says the beginning of the strife is like that. One word, oh, no, they didn't. The second word, oh, they trying to start beef. The third word, you start getting upset. It says, stop it, go turn that pipe off before it gets out of hand. I think we were talking about that yesterday with the pride. He that justify the wicked and he that condemn the just, even they both are an abomination. And this is one, look, I gotta switch hands on this one. Y'all know I'm holding the camera today, so it may be a little unsteady, but I gotta switch hands on that one. He that justify the wicked. It's low toe. We justify bad things because we have vested interest in them. And that, again, is low toe. We let emotions, like I saw a post, a good one today, emotions and feelings override what's righteous. And because they may be our friend or because they might be our brother, we're not going to say truly what it is or what they did wrong because of that connection. That the scripture says that is an abomination. That's wickedness. Let's not. And that was one thing I never had a problem with. And that's probably one of my, but that's your brother. I don't care. They did wrong. They did wrong. But that's, I don't care. They did wrong. They did wrong. The same thing I would expect for somebody to think of myself. If I did wrong, I did wrong, regardless of the relation, no respect of person. So, and that is one thing that agitates me, is when that we as people don't want to say because partiality. I'll just leave it at that. And I told you I wasn't going to be long today because my arm, I could only imagine. Moshe was out there with his hands up. You know, they had to help him hold his hands up because that's like a lot of work. Okay, he that beget a fool doeth to his sorrow, and the father of a fool hath no joy. I had to mention this one because in the other episodes I was like, you know, mommy's always getting the bad end of the deal, but this time daddy caught it. He that beget a fool, it is to his sorrow, and the father of a fool have no joy. See, daddy got some too. So here we go. Solomon is being just. He's evening it out to say that, you know, sometimes we get all excited. Oh, we having a baby. We jumping up and down. Ooh, we having children. Let's pray for righteous children. Because people, everybody has children, the wicked and the righteous. But what's the difference? Some come to give you headache and some come to give you joy. And so sometimes when I'm pregnant and having children and they say, what do you want? I say, a healthy child. You know, because I know beyond the excitement of the child, you got to rear that child for the next 20 plus years. And you better pray that's a good child. Lastly, it says, even a fool, when he hold his peace, is counted wise, and he that shutteth his lips is esteemed a man of understanding. So I'm about to shut my lips right now. I'm going to bid y'all a blessed day. Shalom, if you haven't subscribed. If you haven't subscribed, do so here. And you can check out the other videos right here. And I want to say thank you for tuning in to A Faithful Life, and have a blessed day. Shalom.